Now, fragments from an out-of-control rocket launched by China more than a week ago have crash-landed back to Earth. Weighing in at 22 tonnes and measuring around 30 metres long, the Long March 5B spacecraft plunged into the Indian Ocean near our cricketers in the Maldives, ending days of speculation over where the debris would hit. According to the space agency, most of the remnants of the vessel burned up during re-entry to the Earth's atmosphere. For more, I'm joined by astrophysicist Dr. Brad Tucker. Brad, this re-entry had experts right across the globe holding their breath and second-guessing. How reckless was it by China to do this? And do we know how much debris actually hit the Earth?
Yeah, look, it really was waiting till the last moments. You know, we kind of got it nailed down with all the models to the last orbit, so kind of a two-hour window. It passed over Canberra in the beginning. 24, 25 minutes later, this actually would have been happening over Perth, right? Essentially, CBD Perth. So there definitely was a lot of worry, and that's because we don't like these uncontrolled things because it's hard to predict. If you're off by a minute, you're off by about 500 kilometers. So that's a really huge area to try and say, you know, because of the speed, prepare in 500-kilometer radius. And so, you know, we don't actually know how much debris landed, partially just because we don't have any ground reports because it landed in the ocean just off the coast of the Maldives, as you said. So it will ultimately be one of these unknowns how much came down, but it is going to be definite that some stuff did come down in that area.
Yep. Now, the Chinese tabloids and media have labelled the threat as Western hype. How often does this happen?
Look, I mean, to the Chinese, too often. They've, and I'm not pinpointing them. They had their Long March 5B, which did this in the Ivory Coast a few years ago. It's ultimately a fundamental design flaw in their rocket system. But this does happen to other countries and companies. SpaceX's second rocket booster did disintegrate over the coast of Washington in the U.S. a few weeks ago. And that was more of a failure or a system malfunction. So this happens more and more. The issue here is that it wasn't controlled. And so, you know, statistically, it was always going to land in the ocean. 70% of the Earth is ocean, so 70% chance. Yep. But that small chance of it landing on the ground was the real worry. And so, you know, there's this catch-22. We're glad it landed in the ocean and no one got hurt. But then China could say, yes, of course, we told you so.
How can we do to prevent it in the future? Sort of us oldies remember Skylab way back when, the landed close to Australia. Can we do anything about this?
Well, yeah, in fact, it was Skylab that forced the international community in space to say we need a plan for the re-entry of our objects. And a lot of groups started designing those systems as part of their craft that went up. The U.S., Russia, Europe, everyone does it. Yeah. And actually, even a lot of the Chinese missions actually still do this. This was a very agreed-upon protocol. But, you know, it's not necessarily legally binding. Now, there are aspects that are being responsible for where the debris lands. In fact, there's now a new resolution that would make the kind of controlled reentry essentially a legally binding part of getting your space launch license, essentially from the UN, that the UK is leading and putting forward. So hopefully all the groups do sign on to this, because that's the only way to really do it, is kind of an international goodwill and pressure, because it affects everyone, right? Yeah. You know, China could have equally have had this landed in their country.
Yep, absolutely. All right, Brad, thank you for that. Good to see you.
Thanks.